So as you can see, we can use just straight up HTML tags inside of our file in order to view it in the browser, and we can build an entire website this way. But there are a couple of additions that we can make to our HTML to ensure that it displays properly in a browser. So let's explore what that structure looks like. I'll jump back to my file explorer, and let's open up the third step, which is called index.html, HTML with structure. Now I'll compare this side by side with our original index.html. Okay, so over here on this side, we have our index.html file. On this side, we have our new step file, which includes the additional structure. So the content is right here, and around the content is a body tag. So again, tags just tell the browser what's inside. In this case, we're saying that this is the body. Now, the reason why this is useful to tell the browser that this content is inside the body is because we can add additional features to our HTML page that will exist in the head. So you can see an opening head tag here and a closing head tag here. And within these is a title tag. And this is called basic HTML and CSS examples. Now what this title will do is show up in our browser. If I jump back to the browser, you can see that right up here we have index.html. This is showing the name of the file because there's no title set for the page. And you'll see this change as we copy the content from this third step over to our index.html file. Other things will also go in this head tag, and you'll see those as we go through the series. And around the entire page is an HTML tag. Here's the starting tag, and here's the closing tag. This is telling the browser that this content is intended to be HTML. Browsers can display other types of content as well, including XML. So we're saying explicitly that this content in here is supposed to be HTML. Normally a browser will default to that, so that's not necessarily a problem, but it does let us use this doctype at the top of the page. And this is probably the oddest looking tag here, and it doesn't have a closing tag. What the doctype tag does is it tells the browser what version of HTML or other protocol like XML to use when rendering this page. HTML is a dynamic language. It's actually changing all the time. The core elements that you use aren't changing that often, but sometimes there's big enough changes in the HTML specifications or spec that the browser needs to be able to support multiple versions and render the content in different ways depending on which version of the HTML is being used. In this case, we're just saying HTML, which will default it to the latest version of HTML5. For most new web projects, this is the recommended doctype. So let's see what this looks like in the browser. I'll copy the code, I'll paste it over here in our index.html file and save it, and then we'll jump back to the browser and refresh. And you can see that now we have basic HTML and CSS examples as the title, and down here the content is virtually identical with the addition of a little bit of spacing at the very top of the page. I'm going to jump back to our editor so we can look at the code. I'll close out this third step